Today I'm going to alter the background to pop the subject using only the tools and Lightroom app. This works on desktop app too if you want to try. So here's the image imported to Lightroom app. I'll do some basic tuning in light menu first. We'll try to recover more details by increasing shadows, reducing highlights, bit of contrast and exposure. Increasing the whites and reducing the blacks to pop the overall image. Going to effects menu, I'm going to drag the dehaze slider to the left to give it a bit of hazy look. Next to the masking filters, here's where I will first separate the foreground, that's the subject, and the tree trunk he's standing on. Here I will first choose select subject, which will hopefully do a good job. This is all done on cloud. Selection is fine here, but I also want to add the tree trunk to the selection. Zooming in first, tapping on this plus or minus button and choosing add to mask. Here I'm going to choose brush, setting the brush size, making the edges harder by reducing the feather to 0%, increasing the flow to 100, brushing on the trunk now, being careful on the edges. If you overdo it, you can use the eraser to erase it out. Here you can see this selection is added to the subject. We'll also duplicate this, which will be needed later. Coming back to the first selection, basically tuning only the subject here. In the light menu, increasing shadows a bit. In color menu, moving the hues a bit towards left to make the backpack more orangish. Now to the duplicated mask. I need to invert the selection, so tapping on the filter, you get these options. Choosing invert mask, so everything but the subject is selected for which we'll be tuning now. In effects menu, I'm going to decrease all the sliders here, dehaze clarity and texture to remove details from the background. Adding bluish tones in color menu. Light menu now, reducing contrast, increase in shadows, also blacks. Reducing whites and now the exposure. We'll reduce the saturation also for now. I'm going to duplicate the filter. First, we'll reset all the sliders by double tapping on them. Just a little increase in saturation here. Duplicating it again. We'll reset the color here. I'll subtract the selection by adding linear filter at the top. You can notice here only the bottom part of the image is selected, excluding the subject too. Reducing the exposure to make it a bit dark. Also the blacks. The trunk is too bright now. We'll come back to that later. Duplicating this again. We'll delete the subtracted linear filter. Resetting the sliders. Now, subtracting the bottom part with a linear gradient filter. Only the top part is selected now. Increasing exposure, reducing contrast, adding bluish tones. Reducing the sliders in the FX menu to the minimum to remove as many details as possible to make it smooth. Now we'll add a radial filter here on top and add brightness to it. Adding exposure and lots of whites. We'll try to add color here, but it won't make much difference. Now, coming to the tree trunk. First, I will duplicate the first mask here. Reset the tuning sliders. Subtracting the selection by adding a linear filter so that only the trunk is selected now. Reducing the brightness by tuning the sliders in light menu. After these edits, moving to detail menu. Here, with masking slider, you can select the subject easily. Sharpening the subject further. Now we'll tune the colors with HSL sliders in color menu mix. Tuning the blues and moving yellow hues towards oranges. Also, reducing vibrance gives a good result too. The final result here. Hope these tips and tricks will be useful to you, and subscribe for more. Thanks for watching.